Today I'm going to show you how to add bubbles to a photo. There are two ways that I'm going to show you how to do this. So one is by using a bubbles brush and one is using an overlay. Let's start with the brush. I have them preloaded and these are available in our online store. So the Urban Rhino Photoshop brushes. And if you select, I'm going to go down and select them here. They should be the last ones I just put on here. And you can do, just to start, I'm going to try 100% opacity. I'm going to do a create a blank, just an empty layer. And my white brush is selected. See if I start putting these on, and depending on how big you want them to be, you can see all the little variations here. These are much more realistic bubbles, and then I'm going to do an overlay here in a second and show you what that looks like. So you just resize however you want and place them wherever you want. If you want to do change them to a color. So for instance, if they were reflecting off of something, you could do that. Or since this is underwater, if you want to make the bubbles a little more kind of a light blue, you could certainly do that. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to use an overlay. So I have all the bubbles overlay. So if you go to place embedded and just select whichever one looks, you know, obviously the most appealing. I would prefer to have more at the top and less at the bottom. I already tried that one and they were a little smaller than what I was wanting. Let's try this one. And I can, obviously you can do more than one layer. So I'm going to set this layer to screen here, and then you can see all the little bubbles there. And if you wanted them bigger, you would just resize your layer like this. So depending on, again, how big you want them to be, hit enter. Try a different layer here and see what these other ones look like. So if I did this one, where there's more at the top, kind of like that. Hit enter, set it to screen again, and you can see how there are more bubbles here at the top. For this particular picture, I don't want a ridiculous amount, so I'm going to use the bubble brush, if it will let me delete it. So using this one, and once I've created these, I'm going to do it in several different layers, but if I were to duplicate the layer, it'll make some of them show up even more. So I'm going to continue going through and making my bubbles, and then after this tutorial here, you'll see the speed edit version of how I completed this whole photo, this whole composite from start to finish. So
you stay connected with Urban Rhino on social media. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, comment below, and of course, subscribe to our channel.